September 25th, 2019, the Yu-Gi-Oh! Vrains anime came to an abrupt end after just 120 episodes, making it at the time the shortest Yu-Gi-Oh! Series ever. And despite the story leaving on a massive cliffhanger, we never knew if we would get another chapter in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Vrains series. Well, after 3+ years, Yu-Gi-Oh! Vrains came to Duel Links, and the story of Vrains continued. This is Chapter 1. At the end of Yu-Gi-Oh! Vrains, Playmaker defeated Ai, and Ai painfully and heartbreakingly died in his arms. Playmaker then disappears into the Vrains, and Soulburner, Revolver, and many others ponder when he will return. We see Playmaker deep inside the network. It seems some sort of data comes online, and all of a sudden, Ai awakens, and the Yu-Gi-Oh! Vrains anime ends. We learned from Duel Links that Soulburner has been offline since the end of Vrains, focusing on his real life and building a future outside of the Vrains. Soulburner is only back because he received an unusual signal while in the real world. While dueling in Duel Links, which has now become part of Link Vrains, he runs into Go Onizuka. We last saw Go when he lost to Ai in the final season, trying to put the pieces of his life back together after he sold his soul to Soul Technologies and was responsible for capturing and thus killing the Earth Ignis. Go has reverted back to his Season 1 persona, a persona that many people in the Vrains loved and many kids looked up to him. Soulburner is very excited by this, since he never got to duel the version of Go that he idolized. Remember, Soulburner loved Go, Playmaker, and Aoi when they stood up to the Knights of Hanoi in Season 1, but by the time Soulburner meets one of his idols, Go has become a shell of the person he once was. So Soulburner finally gets to duel the version of Go he rooted for so heavily. Soulburner, of course, wins this duel just like he did the first time they met. Go then reflects on his past. He understands he made a lot of mistakes during his journey in the Vrains anime, and that only caring about his pride cost him everything. He seems to have made a full 180 and has reverted back to who he was when we first met him, a guy who fights for people who root for him and feels he can't let down the kids at the orphanage that support him. And after all this, maybe Go doesn't have to go. Soulburner continues battling throughout the Duel Links, trying to find the person who sent that weird signal that got him back into the Vrains in the first place. Soulburner then reaches what he believes to be the edge of Duel Links. His exploration has taken him to the edge of the virtual world. It is at that time that an unknown voice calls out to him, informing him that the next part of the world has not been built yet. That unknown voice, the voice of an old friend, Soulburner's best friend, Playmaker. Soulburner, shocked, immediately scolds Playmaker for not informing anyone that he has made his return, letting him know that Kusanagi has also been very worried about him. Playmaker then informs Soulburner that he didn't want anyone to know he was here. The reason for that? Ai, Playmaker's partner and Ignis, has somehow come back to life and greets Soulburner. Remember, the last time we saw Ai, he died in Playmaker's arms. Playmaker set off to try and find him, and the final scene is Ai waking up in some strange location. Well, I propose that this final Vrain scene is Ai waking up in Duel Links. Soulburner is shocked that Ai has come back to life. Without offering any explanation, Playmaker continues to be very hesitant in telling Soulburner what's going on. And what happens in Yu-Gi-Oh! When one character wants to learn more about the plot? Well, they duel, of course. Soulburner challenges Playmaker to a duel to learn what's going on, and Playmaker accepts. A duel that we never got to see in the Vrains anime commences, and while this duel would have been amazing to see, the impossible eventually happens. And I feel like it's canon, I really do. And in canon, Soulburner beats Playmaker. He never said that. Shit, man, that duel would have been so good. Honestly, if anyone was capable of beating Playmaker, it was him. It's over. One of the most incredible undefeated streaks ends as Playmaker takes an L against Soulburner. Playmaker then has no choice but to tell Soulburner everything he knows. We learn that Duel Links is a new area that suddenly appeared in Link Vrains. Most likely it went online right at the very end of the Vrains anime. We can infer this because Playmaker solemnly tells Soulburner that I showed up at the same exact time as Duel Links did. As soon as Link Vrains restarted in this new version with Duel Links being a part of it, Playmaker instantly sensed I's presence. I imagine this is the scene we see in the final shot of Vrains. Playmaker went to the deepest areas of Duel Links because that's where he sensed I's presence. That could also be represented by the final scene we see of Playmaker traveling into this quote-unquote unknown world, which is crazy. Playmaker then reveals that's where he found I, but it was a new I. However, this I still remembers everything that happened in his life. Soulburner proposes that maybe this is one of I's clones that he created right at the end of the show, but that theory is quickly put to rest by Playmaker himself, who confirmed that all of those clones were deactivated and that I erased them all on his own. Soulburner and Playmaker have no idea how I is alive, and how this is a new I, even though he has all his memories, which is an aspect that confuses me as well. Playmaker is attempting to answer three questions: what caused I to resurrect, which he feels must have to do with Duel Links, to investigate and uncover what Duel Links actually is, and then third, is that he must protect I. Playmaker believes Revolver will eventually come for I, and Playmaker will not let him get to the Ignis. Soulburner suggests that Playmaker should ask Soltek what Duel Links is, since they run Link Vrains, but Playmaker believes that Soltek is just monitoring what's actually happening with Link Vrains' Duel Links and isn't responsible for creating it, which is super fascinating because it kind of implies that this was created by a potential unknown character or presence. Soulburner decides that he will fight alongside Playmaker to help hold off any threats that I might face, referencing Flame and his reasoning to help Playmaker as well. Whether the other Ignis were revived when Duel Links came into existence remains to be seen, but it's certainly a possibility. We then get some great dialogue between Playmaker and I directly about what happened at the end of the show. I acknowledges his emotions were paused when he fought against Playmaker, to which Playmaker responds by telling I that his simulations may have been wrong, and that you cannot actually predict the future. In case you forgot, I ran thousands of simulations, which all ended with Playmaker getting killed. That was a big reason he went down the path that he did in the final season. But Playmaker is not convinced that those simulations would have been accurate, because Bowman also tried to simulate the duels against Playmaker and completely failed. Bowman was confident he could not possibly lose to Playmaker in his final form because of those same simulations, which ended up being wrong. So Playmaker believes that every simulation is just one possibility, and that I cannot confidently predict the future because anything can happen or change the outcome. It's the same mindset that he believes plagues Revolver. Revolver, based on simulations, believes that the Ignis will destroy humanity, but he does not know that for sure. He reiterated that our actions determine the future, not simulations. Playmaker then has some really humanizing dialogue where he expresses major regret and guilt for not being able to save the Ignis in that Bowman duel. Playmaker requests I to fight alongside him once again, just like they did up until that Bowman duel. I accepts, and one of the greatest 1-2 duos in Yu-Gi-Oh! Reunite once again to unlock the mysteries that Link Vrains Duel Links has bestowed upon them. Thank you all so much for watching. This is just chapter 1 in the post-Vrains story. The Blue Angel Aoi Zaizen event will be chapter 2, and that video will be up soon. We know a Revolver event is coming towards the end of January, and I will certainly be making another video whenever we get some massive storyline developments. Honestly, this is awesome. I never expected Duel Links to continue the story of Yu-Gi-Oh! Vrains, and it's so cool that we are getting what I feel like we were robbed of with Yu-Gi-Oh! Vrains ending as quickly as it did, lasting only 2.5 years, where all the other shows lasted at least 3 years up until Vrains. So let me know your thoughts on this story so far. Let me know any predictions with where you think this story might take us, and just let me know your general thoughts in the comments down below. Thank you all so much for watching. A special thank you to my Platinum tier patron, Panther J, to my Diamond tier patrons, Latrell Smith and Jesse Woods, and to my Egyptian God tier patron, Pink Penguin. Thank you to everyone who supports me on Patreon and whoever is a YouTube channel member. You guys help me out so much. And if you want some exclusive channel perks, definitely check out both of those sites and features. Be sure to check out my channel for more Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime content. And until next time, I hope you have an amazing day. Take care, guys.